Hello children, your ma'am is back. Welcome to your EVS class. I hope you all have enjoyed last two sessions and also finished your homework. Today we will study the next topic of the same chapter, the plant fairy. Kids, let's begin the session 3. I am sure you all will enjoy. Before we start today's topic, children, let's recapitulate the previous session. In session 2, we had learned many things about the leaves. Leaves are green in color. They are flat and thin. Different leaves have different shapes and sizes. The color of leaf is green due to the presence of chlorophyll. Different parts of leaf. Leaves have different parts, as I had already explained. The main parts of a leaf are lamina or leaf blade, midrib, veins, stipule, petioles, and the leaf tip. Functions of a leaf. Leaves have many tiny pores called stomata. It helps the plant to breathe. Plant releases extra water through the leaves, and this process is known as transpiration. So, these are the functions performed by the leaf. Students, I hope you must have understood all these topics. Now, today we will discuss the question answer from the textbook. Refer page number 16. Question number 1. Look at the picture and name the things which have patterns of leaves and flowers on them. Children, look at the picture very carefully and you have to find out the things which have the patterns of leaves and flowers. In the given image, the patterns of leaves and flowers can be found on the painting, the frame of painting, the pillow covers, the carpet, and the dress of the girl. So, these are the things which have patterns of leaves and flowers. Children, refer page number 17. Here, the question is, look for the objects which have patterns of leaves and flowers on them in your house. Write their names. Children, in my house, I can see so many objects that have the patterns of leaves and flowers. I have listed out their names as I can see the patterns in curtain, carpet, bed sheets, pillow covers, dress, tiles, and the picture frames. Now, you will find the objects which have the patterns of leaves and flowers on them in your house and write their names in your EVS notebook. Now, refer page number 17. Here, the question is, you must have seen many plants and trees. How many of them can you name? Write their names. Children, I have seen many plants and trees. I am sharing some names of trees and plants with you all. Tulsi, neem, banyan, marigold, pipal, aloe vera, jasmine, lily. But you can write the answers according to your choice. Free fall, page number 17. Move on to the next question. Are there any plants that you have heard of but never seen? Which ones? Yes, I have heard of many plants, but there are some plants which I have heard of but never seen. Children, I am sharing some of them with you all. The first one is the Franklinia. This plant is mostly found in the river valleys of Georgia in United States. It has the beautiful white colored flower. Next, the rhododendron. Rhododendron is mostly found in Asia and North America. The type of the plant is shrub. Here you will see the image of the beautiful flower, that is Rafflesia. It is mainly found in Indonesia, Malaysia, Thailand. The beautiful flower smells like the rotting flesh that attracts many insects. The another name of the Rafflesia is the corpse flower. Students, now you can also share the name of some plants that you have heard of but never seen. Come to the next question. Ask some older people if there were plants which they have seen when they were children but are not seen these days. Children, now I am sharing some names of the plants that had been seen before many years but not seen these days. Well, the first one is ebony. It is mainly found in Karnataka. Nowadays, they are very rarely found. The ebony wood is very expensive. Next, the bird's foot plant. It is mostly found in Gujarat and in the temperate grasslands in Asia. The flowers of the plant are used for making the medicine. Next, the pitcher plant. It is mostly found in Mount Victoria and in Philippines Island. This plant has the pitcher-like structures which attract the insects. Children, these are some name of the plants that had been seen before many years but not seen these days. Friendship with a tree. Children, choose a tree near your school or house and make friends with it. What tree is it? Children, can you identify the name of the tree? Yes, it's a mango tree. Does the tree bear flowers or fruits? Here in the image, you can see the mango and the flowers. So, the tree bears both the flowers and fruits. How do the leaves of the tree look? Children, here you can see the image of the mango leaves. The leaves are oval, pointed at the tip with wavy edge. Next, do animals live in the tree? Which one? Yes, I can see the monkey, and the squirrel living in the tree. Students, here is your home assignment. Now, you have to write these answers in your EVS notebook. That's all for today. I have explained the whole chapter. I hope you all have understood and enjoyed the session. Now go through the chapter thoroughly. Thank you.